Hey guys, it's me and welcome back to the channel. So today we'll be doing a quick little how-to on how to charge your little 1S batteries that you use for your micro, such as this one. It can be a little 520 milliamp hour battery or a 720 milliamp hour battery or a 600 milliamp hour battery, such as this Nanotech from Hobby King. They're all different mAhs or milliamp hours, but I'm not sure where people are getting that they cannot charge different mAhs with this little ISDT charger, because I've been doing it for, I don't know, maybe a couple of months now, and it's pretty okay. All the batteries are healthy. They still have their original, I would say, power, and they've been working fine for me. So what I did was, like I said, I do have an ISDT charger, a SC608. It's a 150-watt pocket charger, I would like to say, because it's so small it can easily fit in your toolbox, even your pocket. You can power it with a power supply, like a 12-volt power supply, like what I have right now, or a bigger lipo, like a 5,000 milliamp hour lipo, a 3S or a 4S, which you might have lying around, which is perfect for carrying into the field. Anyway, since we're at home, we're using the power supply right now. So like I said, we're going to be charging five 1S batteries. I purchased this little parallel charging cable off from Banggood. It's basically, I think, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 charging leads that connect up to these batteries. And the other end, when you purchase it from Banggood, is just I think it was the similar power lead, which I changed to by simply soldering on a XT60, and this end pops in into the ISDT charger. Okay, so the thing is to remember when charging multiple batteries of different mAhs like these is to make sure that they have equal voltage, or at least very near each other. Okay, so what we'll do, using a little battery checker I have here, this is a really old battery checker, I've had it for, I don't know, maybe 3 years already. I check the battery voltage. See, one cell, it's 3.77 volts, okay? So I put that aside for now. Check another one, it's 3.82, okay? So I put that here. Check another one, 3.9, okay? So you can see they're all different, right? And check this one, 3.73, okay? So I have them here. I'm not gonna charge this Nanotech for now, because I think this is already charged, I'm not sure. But anyway, I'm gonna charge these four batteries. So this is a 3.9, this is a 3.8, and both of these are around 3.7, okay? So they're all different. They're slightly near each other, but the thing to do is, that the trick is, you plug them in, okay, into the charger, I mean the leads, okay, sorry about that, taking a while, anyway, there you go, so they're all plugged in right now, but don't charge them, because they're different voltages, they need to settle down and drain each other out. Not really drain to zero, but balance each other out. So the 3.9 is obviously higher than the 3.7 and the 3.8 cells, right? So what's going to happen is the 3.9 will bleed off some of its capacity, I would say, or electricity, to the lower cells. And then you go back after 5-10 minutes, they would be equally balanced at around 3.8. That's what I've found using this method. So even their different mAhas, this is I'm not sure if you can see, hopefully you can see. There, a 550 mAha battery, and the rest of them are 720 mAha. So about 130 milliamp hour difference, which is pretty okay. But anyway, we'll go back in 5 minutes, and I will show you. I will disconnect these batteries from the charger, and I will show you that they have equally balanced themselves out. So I'll go back after 5 minutes. Hey guys, so we're back after 5 minutes or so, and now we can check what milliamp hours the battery have right now, what capacity, to see if they settle down into their normal, equal voltages. Let's disconnect them one by one, and I'll show you right now. Okay, let's take battery number one. By the way, I label my batteries with a Sharpie, so it's easier to keep track of. Which one is used? That is now 3.81. Okay. Battery number two is at a 3.80. So perfect. They're both 3.8. And battery number three is at 3.80 as well. Very good. And the last one, battery number four. 3.82, which is also good because they're all at 3.8. The last decimal digit, that's fine. You don't have to think about that. Now, what we just have to do is connect these up back to the ISDD charger and see what charging rate we can charge it at. Actually, there's only one charging rate that I charge at, which is 1C, or basically one amp hour, I think that's correct. So I have 3720. What was that again? Yeah, 700. Oops, 720. I have three of those, right? And I have one 550 milliamp hour battery. So 720 times three is 7 times 3 is 21, and then all right, 2.6. That's 2.6 amps for the three of these. Plus you add your 0.5, which is 3.1. So 2.6 plus 0.5 is basically 3.1, and that is what you will set your charger at. Okay, I'm trying to do this through the camera, so pardon me. I will set it at 3.1. There you go. And make sure the LiPo is selected, charge 1S, and simply press start. It will say that do you want to perform unbalanced tasks? That is fine because we are charging 1S LiPos. Just click yes. And it's now charging. So after, I don't know, 30, 35 minutes, all of these will be charged, and I will come back later and show you that they're all charged up to, I think, 4.2 will be the correct value. Okay? See you later.
Hey guys, I'm back. So the charger's beeped after around 50 minutes. You can see here. So it says fast charge done, so that is good. Usually takes like 40, 45, sometimes 30 when I haven't drained all the packs, but now it's at 50 minutes, which is still right, still another hour. So that is the trick to charging multiple 1S batteries with different milliamp hours or different capacities. Just make sure that when you're charging them, they're around the same voltage. 3.7, 3.8, 3.9. 0.2 voltage difference is not much of a biggie. That's what the limit of I would be at when charging these batteries. So obviously don't put in a freshly, charged battery, which is around 4.2 volts. And then combine it with other drain batteries, because the drain batteries would have too much amps going into them from the 4.2 volt battery. So anything that's 0.2 volts of a difference, 3.7, 3.8, 3.9, that's totally fine. And then just leave it on for about 5 to 10 minutes, let them balance out, and that should be all right. So yeah, if you like the chat, if you like my video, please don't forget to comment, like and subscribe, and for more videos. Thanks you guys, and happy flying.